And welcome back to the second half of our Pokemon Anniversary History of Pokemon discussion. We are on Generation 4 now, going through Generations 4 through 6. So Generation 4 consists of a lot of games. Pokemon Diamond, Pokemon Pearl, Platinum, HeartGold, SoulSilver, which are remakes of Gold and Silver, of course. There was Pokemon Battle Revolution. Pokemon Dash, I think, counts. Pokemon Explorers of Time and Darkness. Two Pokemon Ranger... Actually, wait, no. Was the third Pokemon Ranger game part of Generation 4? I think it was, yeah. It
doesn't matter.
Pokemon Generation Guardian Signs and Shadows of Almia. And what else am I forgetting? I mentioned Pokemon Mystery Dungeon, Battle Revolution. Okay, I think I actually mentioned everything. There's also, like, a few other things. I believe there Pokemon Rumble...
There's Pokemon Rumble for the Wii Virtual, for the WiiWare.
Yes. Okay, so the first Pokemon Rumble game started here. There is a huge expansion of shit. Pokemon Conquest, I think.
That was the end.
That was the tail end of Generation 4, I believe.
I think it was
it?
No, that's Gen 5.
Yeah, that was Gen 5.
Gen 5? Okay.
Yeah,
so
it was the last. It was like the last DS game.
Okay, so that's Generation 4, and we have about a little. We have somewhere in the realm of two-thirds to three-fourths of a dozen games to talk about here. And most of us have probably not touched half of them, because, honestly, some of them just don't matter. But, Jack, you can fill us in on your involvement with Generation 4 and how disappointing it was for you.
Lennon, you mentioned that Pokemon Conquest was like the last DS game,
It was like one of the last ones.
It came out like 6 months before Black and White 2.
It was like one of the last ones.
It was one of the last ones.
It was like one of the last ones. That's what I said.
Okay. So Gen 4, Diamond and Pearl. I bought Diamond, and my first starter was Chimchar. And when I first played it, I really enjoyed it. You know, when I first played it, but like looking back and like, you know, going back to, you know, like Gen 3 after playing Gen 4, I think, wow, is this game faster than I remember? No, Diamond's just really, really slow, which would be fixed in Platinum. But, you know, like at the same time, I also didn't notice it too much. Well, I mean,
really...
I did kind of notice it.
If you were a kid, you probably didn't notice it, but if you were older, you definitely noticed it.
Yeah, I was like 3 days from turning 12 when Diamond and Pearl came out, and I got that one for my birthday, and I played all the way up to like the fight with Cyrus. Right before you catch Dialga on my first day.
Wow.
Wait. First 2 days. I got that far on Saturday.
My bad.
My birthday was on a Friday that year. No, my birthday was on a Thursday that year. Fuck! I can't remember anything.
When was your birthday?
I actually remember my first experience with Pearl, like the back of my hand, but anyway, you can go on.
Oh god, when did that get there?
I embedded it into him.
Oh, when?
I enjoyed it. You know what, for all intents and purposes, Gen 4 is my second least favorite generation as far as like the main games are concerned. But I still enjoy them. I mean, I haven't played them in years and years, but that's because like I played them like a fuckload when they first came out. And I kind of got sick of playing them because I played them so much. I kind of want to go back to them at some point, honestly, or Platinum specifically, because Platinum is the
definitive version.
Definitely the definitive version. I like the music is okay, and the gym leaders are good. And I really like Sinnoh as a region. I do. Like, almost as good as Hoenn for me. in terms of just like things to do and just like how like diverse the region is in terms of like biomes and shit. But one thing that I absolutely hate about like Gen 4 though is the required use of HMs all over the place.
That's like why that's one of the reasons why I actually hate Gen 4 so much.
Like Mount Cornet, I'm pretty sure requires like 6 different HMs.
It requires Rock Smash later on. You need Waterfall in a couple of places. Strength, Surf, I believe there's I think there might have been a room where you need a Defog.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there was a room where you need a Defog.
I don't think it needs Flash, though.
Wasn't this the generation where Flash became a TM instead of an HM?
No, Flash became a TM in Generation 5.
Okay.
Wait. I'm trying to think of the...
Hold on.
Wait, no, you're right. It did become a TM, this one. Because the HMs were Cut, Eye, Surf, Strength, Rock Smash, Defog,
Waterfall,
and
Rock Climb.
Yeah.
No, Rock Climb.
Rock Climb.
Whirlpool was Gen 2.
Whirlpool was, yeah. Waterfall and Rock Climb. So, yeah, no, you're right. They turned Flash into a TM. You needed Surf, I believe. I think I mentioned that, though. But anyway. Yeah.
Overall, I do like the games, just not as much as other generations. Heart Gold and Soul Silver. Oh my god. My dick.
Stop it.
These games.
Stop it.
No. They make your dick hard too. Don't deny.
Stop it.
No. Never. So I bought Soul Silver the day it came out, mostly because I played like Silver was my first Pokemon game, and they're fucking amazing. Heart Gold and Soul Silver. And Landon's going to be like, oh, but they're not the original, so they're wrong.
They are Landon. Not the originals, and their music is wrong until you get the GBA player. Then it's better.
Landon? Shush.
Fuck you.
I'll probably explain it when I get into it.
Yeah, so Heart Gold and Soul Silver are really, really fantastic games. Probably, definitely the best remakes in the franchise.
Yeah, I guess I won't argue against that. I mean, I will say I have a personal bias for Fiber and Leaf Green just for the sheer amount of shit that they do add on. But I mean, Heart Gold, Soul Silver were, you know, they were really good too.
Yeah. I'm not sure.
Also, one what thing else? That Heart Gold, Soul Silver did that they really like, I'll mention that when it's my turn, though, actually. Go ahead.
I'm not sure what else I have to say about those games, aside from the fact that I just really enjoyed playing them. Pokemon Dash. Fucking awful. Fuck Pokemon Dash. I had a friend that bought Pokemon Dash, and I'm just like, I played it, and I'm just like, wow, this is really boring.
This is good stuff.
Go, Landon. Shut the fuck up.
What else is there?
Explorers of Time and Darkness are really good. Better than the Red and Blue Rescue Team.
Red and Blood Rescue Team.
Yes. Crips and Bloods Rescue Team.
I'd play that.
those were really good games, and the story is really good, just generally probably better. Yeah, no, just better. What else is there aside from Battle Revolution, because I'm gonna fucking save that one for last.
The other two Ranger, the other two Pokemon Ranger games.
I did not play.
No, that's actually about it for this generation.
Okay, fuck Pokemon Ranger. It's Pokemon Stadium, but without the cool mini games and without Gym Leader Castle.
Yeah, fuck Pokemon Ranger.
Wait, goddamn it! God damn it!
Fuck Pokemon Ranger.
It cost him PTSD.
Yeah, fuck Pokemon Ranger.
Fuck. I'm sorry.
Battle Revolution.
I'm sorry, I liked Pokemon Ranger.
But fuck it anyway.
But yeah. Fuck it anyway. Fuck Pokemon Battle Revolution and all those things that I said earlier. It's Pokemon Stadium without the cool minigames and fucking Gym Leader Castle. It's boring as fuck. Especially if you don't have, like, a fucking DS with Diamond or Pearl.
Is fucking really boring? Why do people say it's boring as fuck? Is, like, sex not appealing to some people?
To some people, yeah.
You're true. I don't need. So I don't need life. I have waifus.
Is that everything you want to talk about for Generation 4, Jack?
I'm gonna remember something like 5 minutes from now and be like, "Oh yeah, and that one thing."
It'll be like, "Shut the fuck up, Jack." You had your chance.
You had your time.
You had your time.
All right. So.
Yeah. Go ahead.
For me, for Gen 4. This is where the burning out starts to take place. I will admit, the first half of Generation 4 went by just as densely packed for me of activity as Generation 3 did, but this is where I started to play so much that I was like, I think I have played too much Pokemon. But I do play Pokemon a lot still, but it got cut down around.
It'd be like saying I play too much Fire Emblem.
Don't
no, not exactly. You don't know that yet. So I got Pokemon Pearl on launch day, and that would be the first in a series of just sweeping, getting every Pokemon game, major Pokemon game on launch day, until Alpha Sapphire, Mega Ruby, and that was just a decision that I had to make because I only had the money to buy that or Smash Brothers, and I had to go for Smash Brothers because I had an agenda on my mind then. But Pearl. It was the first game I would get on launch day that would create a giant series of giant trend for that. I ended up getting it, as I mentioned in the previous video, the day after I got my DS Lite. It was a Sunday, and it took me 6 days to beat, and I was playing it almost every hour that I wasn't in school, and I beat it the Saturday morning after, and I fucking loved Pokemon Pearl. I will admit, Jack is right, it is a slower game. It takes forever to save if you even touch a PC. Like, if you even touch a PC.
Fuck saving a lot of data.
Yeah, saving a lot of data. That was the biggest problem with Diamond Pearl, in my opinion, was just extremely long save times. But I loved it. The Sinnoh region is a huge... It's much like Hoenn, where it's like it's a huge, sprawling mass of places to explore. But thankfully, it's not filled so much with water.
Okay, Snake.
I didn't mind the fact that it needed a lot of HMs, but then again, if you really, really want to explore a lot in Hoenn, it's not as bad about it, but you still do really need a lot of HM usage. So I was just kind of used to it. I really liked the new Pokemon that they added a lot, and coming off of a generation that was trying to put in a bunch of fresh Pokemon, I liked the fact that they had a bunch of new evolutions and did something similar with the Pokemon, like they did for Gen 2, where they added new things and then they added evolutions for old stuff. The gym leaders, I really enjoyed the gym leaders. They're probably like my second favorite set, honestly, next to Kanto. I think the only set that I could argue comes close to Diamond and Pearl set of gym leaders for me would maybe be Johto, actually. I really like Sinnoh's gym leaders. Volkner's my favorite gym leader, and some of my favorite evolutions going back to that point come from Generation 4. So Generation 4 just did a lot of great things for me. Generation 4 introduced the physical special split, which is one of the greatest things.
Oh, yeah, that's good.
Which is one of the greatest things I found in Pokemon. It was necessary. There was Pokemon like Gyarados who got the shit end of the stick from Generation 3, moving away from with a new... there was a new data structure in place for Generation 3. We didn't mention that, but it was like kind of an underlying thing that affected how Pokemon stats were. And in Generation 4... they kind of remedied a lot of Pokemon suffering from that, and they gave them some extra cool stuff. So Gyarados has Waterfall be physical, or, you know, Alakazam gets... he ended up losing the Elemental Punches, but he gets stuff like Energy Ball and Focus Blast, and he gets Shadow Ball, I believe. because Shadow Ball was switched to Special. They added a lot of really new, really cool attacks on both ends of the spectrum to compensate for this. So there's really important moves that came out, like Stealth Rock is a really great entry hazard move. They came out with stuff like Dark Pulse, Stone Edge, just a lot of really cool stuff going on a addition level of Diamond and Pearl. Not a lot of whole crazy new cool stuff, but updating it did a really good job with. Cynthia's my favorite champion. There's just no contest there, so I'm gonna be biased as fuck with that. I really like the music, but at the same time, I like it for a different reason, because it's not iconic like the first three generations managed to do with their themes, both overworld and battle. But the overworld music did a really cool job of making like nice ambience music. Like I liked exploring because of like the ambience that would go on, like going into like spooky Eternal Forest and going in to catch Rotom in the chateau, or going through the whatever the fuck the name of that area was, where you go get Giratina, the little forest cave, the little forest entrance leading up to that, and then going in.
I was going to say the Cave of Origin, but that's Gen 3.
No, the lakes where you get the Sinnoh Trio, just a lot of really cool exploring places, and the music that accompanies them is just like this mystical feeling of, ooh, adventure. I like that. I played the shit out of Pearl. I got 730 hours on that, on a file for Pearl. And there was a lot of breeding going on in that. Yes, there was. I was obviously disappointed by the lack of certain things that Emerald and Fire and Leaf Green had done a little bit better. The Versus Seeker doesn't really give you as much of, you know, really cool fights to redo like Fire Red Leaf Green did, but Fire Red Leaf Green also had Sevii Islands to help with that. What else? Emerald had the Battle Frontier, which Diamond and Pearl did not have. Thankfully, it comes back in Platinum, but in my opinion, not as good. Platinum fixed a lot of the stuff that was wrong with Diamond and Pearl. They, you know, made it better. I got Platinum on the same launch day, March 22nd, 2009, I think it was. I appreciated a lot of the improvements the Platinum had made. I don't really care for the rival of Sinnoh, honestly. He's probably one of the weaker rivals, in my opinion. He doesn't really have much going for him. I think the only rivals that could be argued to be less entertaining than him would be Hugh, maybe, from Black White 2, and whatever you consider a rival character from XY, because I didn't really give a shit about them at all. But so Diamond and Pearl, I think that covers that. There was like a battle zone area that you could go to after you beat the game, which was kind of neat. Catch Heatran, stuff like that. The legendaries for Diamond and Pearl, I will admit, the fourth generation legendaries are all over the place. They are really weird. Like, there was a little bit of cohesiveness going on throughout the generations for legendaries, and that continues onward in the next generations. But I feel like Game Freak, when they were coming up with legendaries, they were just like, fuck it, that's a legendary Pokemon. Like, Heatran almost makes no sense to be a legendary Pokemon, aside from the fact that it's just considered a legendary Pokemon. Cresselia and Darkrai are cool, but I mean, they don't really actually interact the way that you think that they would. Shaymin is also just kind of like sitting around there. Giratina, Palkia, Dialga are like the only ones that really have a lot of, you know, going for them and Arceus. And then there's the duo that literally just looks like Mew, copy and pasted three times and photoshopped. I mean, I didn't really care for them. I just liked exploring to find them, but Regigigas. I don't even want to talk about Regigigas. That's sad.
But he's made after Regifisame.
He is Regi incarnate.
He is Regi.
He's Regi.
He's a sad excuse for a legendary. If you guys are calling him Regi, you are insulting Regi, okay?
No, but that's the thing. He's like literally a Pokemon that was made for Regi.
Yeah, that's literally Regi.
I'm really sad they made him for Regi, because they did not make him a very good Pokemon. There's Manaphy, which for some reason can breed and make Fionn, which is disputed its legendary status. People don't even know if they want to consider that a legendary Pokemon. That is how just the legendary Pokemon in of Generation 4, just, I don't know. But
why would you even ever want to use Fion if you have Manaphy?
I don't know.
To complete my goddamn Pokedex, goddammit.
It's literally worse than Manaphy in every aspect, way. And it cannot evolve.
And it cannot evolve into Manaphy either.
Want to?
Is that the one you breed into?
Yeah.
But, Hawaii, Desu, Desu?
Plus side, there's a really cool Pokemon that did come out, like Garchomp for new Pokemon. Spiritomb's pretty cool. Lugia's pretty cool. For evolutions, you have stuff like Gallade, and you have a couple new evolutions coming out in this generation, actually. You had some other evolutions I liked, like Electivire, Rhyperior. So there's some cool stuff going on there. I ended up getting HeartGold out of HeartGold SoulSilver on launch day as well, which that was really great. I liked the PokeWalker app, toy feature app thing. I didn't really use it that much after I was done with my initial, you know, trying to toy with it and test it out like everybody does with something new, but I thought it was cool. I also really liked, just as I was going to mention earlier, one thing I did like about HeartGold SoulSilver above every other aspect when it comes to design-wise is it did something that with the Kanto region, it had to be condensed for Gold Silver for it to fit, and they just re-expanded and just opened the Kanto region back up to its full size in HeartGold SoulSilver. So it is a massive, massive game with all of the areas that you have in that game. Obviously, as Landon mentioned, you get cool stuff like the GB sounds, as well as possible gym leader rematches, and the Battle Frontiers carry over to HeartGold SoulSilver. So HeartGold SoulSilver, unfortunately, it only lasted a year before it was superseded by the next generation, but it had so much cool stuff going on for it. I played Battle Revolution. It's okay. But the only good attraction to it that Jack did not get to touch upon, if you have Diamond and Pearl or any Generation 4 game and you bring your Pokemon in, you can then use those Pokemon online against other people. And unlike in Diamond and Pearl and the other games, it's a lot easier to do that, in my opinion, to just play random strangers online than it is in other. Then again, my Wi-Fi situation was also very poor overall, so I didn't really get to experience it as well. So when I played Battle Revolution, everything just worked out a lot better. But like Jack said, I do like the character customization in Battle Revolution. I just wish that they would have made a game besides XY that did a better job of, you know, putting that in a game and not having it belong to a crappy game, because Battle Revolution otherwise was not very interesting. I think the only reason I really played Battle Revolution was for the character customization. I played Explorers of Darkness. I got that on launch day, actually. It was really good and really fun. Story was better. Everything about it just about is better than the original. I mean, it was just basically the perfect follow-up for the Mystery Dungeon series. I didn't get to play the Ranger games that came after or anything else besides those games in that generation. So my Generation 4 experience was very much just main series and then a little bit of Mystery Dungeon on the side. I will say overall Generation 4 main core series was probably my favorite, but at the same time, everything around it, and it has its own faults, are definitely up for critiquing, because unlike Generation 3, which had a much more solid, you know, full base with side games and stuff like that, it was good, but Generation 4 has some pretty bad side material, honestly, outside of a few things. I guess it's worth noting that there were some Japanese exclusive Mystery Dungeon games also, but you know, that's about all I have to say about Generation 4. I liked it, but there was like nothing really else going for it besides what I actually got to play. Justin?
Yeah?
Did you want to talk about Generation 4?
I found it really boring. I Gen 4 is actually my least favorite generation.
A lot of people feel that way.
Then it got way too HM heavy. It's like, you need more than just a slave Pokemon to get through some of that shit.
But Beborella's best HM slave.
Yeah, well, it doesn't help.
He can literally learn two HMs that are the same type as him, so he gets stab bonus off it.
Yeah, well, you can only learn four moves.
You can teach him four HMs. And yeah, the other four HMs are usually not that often used anyway.
Still, that's moves that could be used for better shit.
Beaverell doesn't get any better shit. Beaverell was invented purely to be an HM slave, I swear on my life.
Oh, which means if you're lying, I get
it's
to
like
kill
a,
you.
A normal water type, like, yeah, definitely.
You literally give it strength. I think it can learn rock climb. And then waterfall, and if it can learn that, surf. And you pretty much are just set with your HMs, with just Beaverell. And he gets stat bonus off it. It's just, like, wonderful. But keep going. Unless you wanted to just pass it over to Landon, I don't know what else you played.
Yeah,
for
I don't have
four.
Many fond things to say about Gen 4.
No Mystery Dungeon.
Oh, Mission, actually,
Because we have Explorers of Time and Darkness.
Actually, Red Rescue Team is the only Mystery Dungeon game I've actually ever played. Because remember, I didn't own a DS.
Ah, yes. All right, so, I guess we're going to move on to Landon then.
But I'm looking at boobs now.
And Landon actually did play Pokemon Rumble, so he gets to contribute that to this.
Pokemon Rumble's fun. You should all go onto your Wii and download Pokemon Rumble, because it's fun. I'm not being paid by Nintendo right now to promote Pokemon Rumble. And
I'm not either, and I don't like Pokemon Rumble.
And you should go buy Pokemon Rumble right now. In fact, while you're buying Pokemon Rumble, you should go to any store that has pre-orders open for Pokemon Rumble World for the 3DS, so you can get your copy, a physical copy of Pokemon Rumble World when that comes out April 29th. Thank you. Have a good day.
All right, so
download Lexine's Quest today.
as for the core Generation 4 games, you can talk about those, or you can talk about Mystery Dungeon first. It's your choice.
But I only played Diamond.
Okay, so talk about Diamond.
Diamond was there. I played a lot of Diamond.
Alright.
Because fuck Pearl. Pearls are for girls. I want diamonds.
I picked Pearl and the penis space dragon thing.
You're a girl. I bet you played as a girl, too.
No, I actually played as a guy.
You are a girl.
Well, he has a scarf, so to be fair, he's pretty...
He's pretty girlish. He's like the girlish girl of Girltown and Girlville.
He's the prettiest princess at the ball.
You want to talk
he
about,
is the prettiest princess at the ball.
What do you want to talk about? Heart
Lucas
gold?
Confirmed for prettiest princess.
What were you saying, Cloud?
Do you want to talk about Heart Gold Soul Silver?
But they're
unless
so
you have,
good.
Unless you have more to say about Diamond
about
Pearl.
Diamond? I've got nothing to say about Pearl.
Alright.
I've got nothing to say about Pearl. But
anything Diamond, to say about Diamond?
Diamond, I played that. I played a lot of that. I had a Diamond. And I stole a Diamond from a museum once. It was a museum heist.
You like to talk about Mystery Dungeons.
He is Sly Cooper.
I am Sly Cooper. Hear me roar.
Are you Nathan Drake?
I'm Sly Cooper. I steal diamonds from museums. I have a foxtail. I'm Sly Cooper.
Is that your persona now?
Don't right, hurt right. my persona.
All right.
Mystery Dungeon was good. There was good stuff there. Which one was it? Pokemon.
It was Explorers of
Darkness. I actually had time. I didn't have Darkness. You're probably Batman too.
Darkness.
I was Batman. You're probably for about
girl.
A month.
You're probably Batgirl actually, because you're a girl.
Get it. I get it.
He gets it. But Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Explorers of Time is like the best. It's like the it's one of the top Pokemon games of all time, ever.
All right.
Ever.
Anything else you want to say about Generation 4?
Pokemon. I rented Pokemon Battle Revolution after playing Pokemon Colosseum and XD and Stadiums. You know what's a huge letdown?
What?
Pokemon Fishing Channel. I don't know. Battle Revolution as well.
It's Pokemon Battle Revolution is pretty disappointing coming off of Colosseum and XD. Hey, you know what we could talk about? My Pokemon Ranch. Let's talk.
Okay, my Pokemon.
All right, that was a thing.
I forgot that was a thing. The only thing that was worth mentioning for my Pokemon Ranch is if you managed to actually deposit as many Pokemon as you could into it, you got Mew. That's it.
But in Pokemon Channel Ruby and Sapphire, it was the GameCube game.
Oh, yeah. So
it is already better than my Pokemon Ranch.
My Pokemon Ranch was a Wii game.
Therefore,
you should go down to your local retro game store and purchase a copy of My Pokemon Ranch.
Wasn't that a WiiWare game?
Yeah, I think it was a WiiWare game.
You should go down to your local retro game store and buy a copy of it anyway. Buy a Wii that has it downloaded onto it.
Just ask specifically if that game is already on the Wii. Hi, can you tell me if my Pokemon Ranch is currently on this Wii system?
I don't know. What do you want me to talk about, man? Because, like, Pokemon Gen 4 is, like, it had good
stuff. I can understand. I'm an oddball when it comes to Gen 4. A lot of people, this is where Pokemon died for them, honestly, and I can understand why. I can understand the sentiment. But for me, I actually really enjoy Gen 4. It was just that I had played so much Pokemon at this point across between Generations 3 and 4 that I started to slow down. But it wasn't because I disliked Gen 4. But there are a lot of people that did not care for it.
Like, I like Heart Gold and Soul Silver. I like the Mystery Dungeon games, and I enjoyed Rumble. And
all right, so
there was apparently other games that existed.
We can move on.
We can move on, or we can
to Pokemon Generation 5.
We could explode. We could do that.
Which that consists of the core titles: Pokemon Black, White, Black 2, and White 2. And also has Pokemon Mystery Dungeon Gates to Infinity. It also has... what else does it actually have?
More Rumble games.
Yes, there's... how many Rumble games are there?
The last... Rumble... Whatever the Wii one is.
Okay, so there was Gates to Infinity on the Mystery Dungeon series. There was there was Pokemon Dream Radar, which connects to Pokemon Black.
Best Pokemon game.
I believe that that's Pokemon Generation 5 was not as long a generation as 3 or 4, so there's not
Pokemon
as much
Conquest. Pokemon Conquest.
There is Conquest too. So we can talk about those. We'll start with Jack.
Talk about it.
Okay.
Please. Please talk about it.
I will mention Pokemon Conquest.
Yes.
It is a game.
Yes.
It's a game that I haven't played, so I have no opinion.
Damn it. Next. Cloud, go. All
right.
Pokemon Conquest.
I can't actually talk about Pokemon Conquest.
God damn it, next.
Jack, did you play?
Justin, talk about Pokemon Conquest.
I've played it.
Did you actually play Pokemon Conquest?
Yeah, it's like a fucking... It's a strategy RPG thingy-ma-boober game, and, like, different Pokemon have, like, different, like, it kind of tries to work like how the actual games work, except, you know, the abilities are more on, like, a strategy scale rather than the standard Pokemon stuff. So, like, sometimes you'll have a Pokemon that maybe can, like, I'm trying to remember. I think it was an ability that like made it so he was harder to hit or something like that. So it was kind of like almost like a skill in Fire Emblem that would activate on random occurrences that did some random thing. And you had like each Pokemon was like tied to one person. I can't really say trainer. And you could recruit like other allies that also had their own Pokemon. Now it was a little bit different than like the actual Pokemon games because it played kind of more like Digimon World, where, or at least the first Digimon World, where you're only allowed one Pokemon for a trainer, so, or whatever the fuck you want to call them. So in order to have like a full team, you'd actually have to have like actual people with you because each person would have their own Pokemon, and I'm trying to remember if it was, like, a wild Pokemon thing, but there's something you could do where you kind of, like, bond with a Pokemon that you meet. So there's, like, some minigame you have to play with it to try and bond with it, and if you fuck up, then it's like, nope, fuck you. But if you manage to actually get it, you get that Pokemon. So it's kind of like the Digimon Captures device from Cyber Sleuth, except instead of just being encounter-based, it's more so just you not being bad at the minigame.
Alright, so let's...
Justin's the true Pokemon fan here. He played Pokemon Coliseum, you two didn't.
Let's back up.
I don't know what...
Let's back up for a second, because...
Lennon, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. I played Pokemon Coliseum.
Pokemon Coliseum's too good.
Okay, guys. We're gonna back up for a second. We're gonna go back to Jack, because Jack didn't really get to talk about Generation 5 as a whole because Landon was pushing everybody through for Conquest.
So alright, my turn to talk about Pokemon Conquest.
You can talk about Conquest when it gets to your turn, because I know you're going to have a lot to say about it. So, but for now, it's Jack's turn to talk about Generation 5 as a whole.
My turn right now.
No, it is Jack's turn.
It's my turn right now.
So go ahead, Jack.
It's my turn.
Landon, do you really want to go right now?
No, I don't.
Exactly. Okay,
so
Black
Pokemon
and White...
Conquest.
So, Landon, go fuck yourself.
Okay, oh, but I'm going to have to close the call then.
Okay, so Pokemon Black and White came out March of 2011, and I bought it the day it came out, like I do with every Pokemon game. I bought White.
Because you're white. I get it.
White supremacy?
I got Black, I'm not racist.
You're a racist. But,
except that White has the Black Legendary.
And Black
so
has the White Legendary.
Reverse,
which means that Cloud is actually the racist one.
Cloud is racist.
Listen.
Anyway.
You're best
racist. Listen, Reshiram has a fur penis. And it cannot be denied.
You're both.
It's true.
You're interested in some weird shit.
The first thing that I noticed when I saw Reshiram's design was just like, that's a dick. You gonna put that away?
No.
I like hanging
so,
out.
The thing that Black and White was trying to push is that it was really trying to be like original, and it is. It has a completely new set of Pokemon for its regional decks. It's like a whole, like, I think it's like 160.
156.
156
not
a Pokemon.
Not a single old Pokemon to be found until after you beat the game.
Unless
yep.
you use Dream World.
Unless
yeah.
Dream World.
And you know what? I like that. It's a nice change of pace. There's like a lot of... Gen 5, you know, like actually I think has a lot of really cool... new Pokemon. I love Chandelure and Darmanitan and Victini. I love Victini. These games... Black and White, hands down the best story in the franchise. Because this gets into, like, more than just a standard, like, villain wants to destroy the world bullshit. It's like a whole, like, kind of morals thing. It's like, are we treating Pokemon poorly? It's like, are these really just, like, cockfights? Do they deserve to be... It's really, like, kind of like a...
You versus PETA.
I mean, it's kind of like a... as much as it'll ever get, it's kind of a thought-provoking story compared to most Pokemon games.
It is probably the only Pokemon game that has made you really think about the concept of Pokemon.
Yeah. It has great characters. N, Sharon, Bianca are all go through like cycles of character development that are cool. The music is fantastic, in my opinion. It has fully animated sprites during battle, which is cool. And what was my first starter? My first starter was Snivy.
Oh yeah, I forgot to mention when we were talking about Gen 4, that Gen 4 was when I started picking water types solid.
No, it wasn't. You said it was an emerald.
It was emerald, I guess.
You said solid.
Yeah, solid.
Well,
solid
to be fair, I played. If we're incorporating the entirety of games together, I did end up getting. What was it? I ended up playing Red Rescue Team afterwards, and I got Bulbasaur. So I mean,
that doesn't matter.
Okay.
This was also the generation where firefighting starters need to stop.
No, that was in Gen 3.
Landon?
Hi.
Shish.
Me.
Okay. But yeah, Snivy for days. He's superior's the best. I don't think I have anything else to say about Black and White 1.
So moving on to Black White 2 then.
So Black and White 2, I kind of almost sort of view these two games as equals, but for different reasons. Black and White 2's story, I'm not even gonna lie, is pretty weak sauce, especially compared to Black and White 1. But I don't know, it's like the fact Black and White 2's regional decks is fucking huge.
300 like compared some odd Pokemon.
Yeah, it's a lot. It's the biggest regional decks.
At the time that it came out, it was the biggest regional decks. I was going to say, this is when they stopped caring about making, like, more restrictive regional decks. They're just like, fuck it, just throw everything in.
You know what? It's like, the sheer variety in Pokemon that you can catch and use for your team just makes the game really replayable, because you can have, like, so many different, like, team combinations in each playthrough. And also, I just found, the different, like, way about going through the region, and just, like, the slight changes that the game makes compared to the original just overall make the game a more fun experience for me. And in terms of just, like, and in terms of just being, like, an overall just, like, fun Pokemon game to play through, it's my second favorite main series game behind Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald. Like I said, the story's the story's pretty weak, like I said, but overall, I did have just a really, really fun time with the game. And what other side games are there to talk about?
All of them.
There's Pokemon Rumble. Last Pokemon Rumble U, which does count because it came out before X and Y. There's also Gates to Infinity in the Mystery Dungeon series, and the Pokemon Dream Radar thing that connects to Pokemon Black and White 2. That's actually about it, though.
I didn't play any of those, so I guess I'm done here.
Alright, so Pokemon Generation 5 for me, I got Black on launch day. I picked Oshawott because that little fucking cute otter thing was just so goddamn adorable, and an otter samurai. It's just what. I really like Black and White though for the story. What Jack mentioned, it is definitely the most solid story wise, and I loved the rivals in this game. The only game in the series that's incorporated as many rivals as it did, and they were all actually good in their own way, because Ruby Sapphire had both Brendan May and then Wally, and, like, one of them is, you know, Wally doesn't really take any importance until after the other one leaves.
Wally's shit, too.
And you, And you kind of get disappointed by the fact that the other one, at least prior to the remakes, doesn't even really get to live up to their full potential before they just kind of sign off and leave.
Yeah.
Because they leave you in their last battle without even fully evolving their starter.
Yeah, that's always something that I thought was kind of, like, odd. I mean, I understand they're, like, that Wally is supposed to be, like, the penultimate rival battle, but, like, it's kind of odd how you just, like, fight them in front of, like, the superstore, and then they just, like, I'm going to go work with my dad. Bye!
And that's it.
And then they die.
There's no climax for them. But
no, there's...
The end.
You know, Diamond Pearl had the one rival, and he wasn't very good, but Black White came out with Charon, Bianca, and Anne all at once, and they all have character development, they all have solid teams of Pokemon, they all have something interesting about them. Bianca's a bumbling idiot that has no idea what she's doing, and then at the end of the game, she knows what she's doing. Charon, he's the opposite. He knows what he's doing at first. He wants to get strong, and then afterwards, he's like, I have no idea what I'm fucking doing. And then Anne is in the middle of this, and he's kind of like a third rival, because he's not really a bad guy, but he's at first, he's almost played up as a bad guy.
He's
not a bad guy either. So he's like, I'm just kind of an antagonist, but not a villainous antagonist. And he has these different Pokemon in each encounter because he doesn't believe in keeping the same ones. And it's just, you got these three things going on, and you got Team Plasma, who are, in my opinion, kind of solid. As a team, their concept, I liked them way more than Team Galactic or Team Magma and Aqua. And in their execution, though, I still think I would prefer Team Rocket more. But Team Plasma was very entertaining, and I really liked them, especially between both games. I don't really care too much for the gym leaders. Generation 5, on a meta sense, I don't care for the gym leaders because they started to ease up on their rosters, and Generation 5 saw a cut in the rosters. So, like, instead of where, like, say, Generation 1, a lot of the latter gym leaders had 4 Pokemon or more. Generation 2 had a lot of 3s and a 4 at the end. And then you had the other gym leaders, which had all 4s and 5s back in Kanto. And then in Generation 3, you had a lot of 3s, and then there was the one exception where you have a gym leader that has 2, and then Wallace has 5. And then you get to Generation 4, which has, like, the 3s and 4 standard. And then you get to Generation 5, and they cut it off at 3. Like, they just decided, you know, no more gym leaders having big rosters of Pokemon. They just have, like, 3 or something, and that's it. So, like, I don't know but for me, like, they're supposed to be, like, considered a boss fight, and they don't feel like a boss fight anymore, because they're just 3 Pokemon, 2 of them aren't even really that important, the other one probably is going to die just as fast as the other two. I do really like the Unova region, though, as a whole. The Unova region is arguably my favorite region, actually. I love how it was cleanly planned out. It's very, very, it is linear, I will admit, but it starts to open itself up, and there's branching areas little here and there that you can go to. So it's very organized, but it still has room for some exploration. I liked how in the Black White one, you didn't even get to explore some of it until after you beat the game. On that note, the Elite Four of Unova, my favorite Elite Four, period. Not even close. There's no competition. I love the Unova Elite Four. I love the fact that they opened up the possibility to fight them in any order so that they're all considered equal. I love their battle music. I love the atmosphere that you're in, like, this old school castle when you fight them all, and they all have their own personalized rooms that are even more personalized than any Elite Four before them, because all the other ones, they didn't really have that personalized of an Elite Four unless it was a remake. Where Platinum kind of, like, made things look a little bit cooler for, like, certain for each one, and then HeartGold SoulSilver did that too. But no, you get, like, this cool personalized room. Like, Chantal's got, like, these books everywhere, and it's spooky and dark. And Marshall's got this giant fucking ring, and Caitlin's got whatever the fuck's going on there, I don't know. And Grimsley.
More books.
Grimsley's got this
she's going
fucking,
to sleep with you.
Grimsley's got this cool, like, fancy little room, and he has hair that looks like the guy from A Flock of Seagulls, just to point that out. don't really know how I feel about Alder as a champion. Battle wise, is just kind of there. I like
Alder's kind of lame, honestly.
I like him conceptually because he didn't want to be the champion. He was just kind of approached and they were like, "Hey, we need a champion," and he was like, "Okay." So he's like a reluctant champion, and I like that concept because all the other champions are like, "Yeah, I'm the champion of the region. I'm like awesome and everything." And Alder's like this, like, "Well, wow. Am I even here? What's going on? Can I please not be champion?" I thought it was actually a cool idea to have a champion who was reluctant to be champion for once. And then Ash takes over for him in Black White 2, which I may as well start talking about now because I basically mentioned everything of note for Black White 1. Black White 2 was fun. I didn't care for the characters. The characters were all pretty boring. I did like the Unova region's touch-ups, though, like Jack was saying. The changes that you get to see take place between the two games are what make Black White 2 that much more entertaining, not necessarily the story, though. The additions of things that were not in the first Black White, though, such as the Pokemon World Tournament was really cool. The Black White 1 only had like a battle subway, which was like a battle tower replacement. I do like the idea of the battle subway, though. It's kind of cool. But no, Pokemon World Tournament is really cool. You get to fight all these old trainers from all the different regions, and you get to kick all their asses. And there's also a lot of legendary Pokemon, like a lot. Like they just threw it all in there. They were just like, "Here you go, here you go, here you go. Here's a legendary. Catch this, catch that, catch this." And just so much going on in Black White 2 in the after game. It's ridiculous. Meanwhile, I will say that the music, as Jack said, was really good. There's a lot of fun stuff going on in the Unova region as a whole, and both of the games managed to really identify that. Like some of the best Pokemon that I feel came out of that generation. Volcarona is one of my all-time favorite Pokemon, just period. I think that really covers the core games, though. The side stuff I didn't really get into. I didn't get to play either of the Pokemon Rumble games that came out at this time. I didn't really play Gates to Infinity too much. I played it for a little while, didn't care for it, just stopped playing it. So my experience with Generation 5 is actually extremely rooted in the core series. I love the core series of Generation 5, but that's all that I really played of it. So that's all I'm going to say about Generation 5. Do I have anything else to say about Generation 5? Nah. They introduced triple battles and rotation battles, where Generation 3 had introduced double battles, but nobody really pays attention to those because they're just way too fucking chaotic.
Because the fucking games don't have enough of them to make them worthwhile.
They should have tried harder to incorporate more of them, yeah, I'll admit. Especially rotation battles. I just thought rotation battles were a really cool concept, though, at least. Because it's like a one-on-one battle, but at the same time it's not, because you can switch something in at any given time without losing a turn. So it's basically just taking it on already known mechanic and just turning it on its head. But, yeah, don't that's worry. About all I have to say don't about...
Every fight in Digimon is a triple battle.
And the legendaries in Generation 5 were really cool, too. Like... I think a couple of my personal favorites do come out of here. Like, I do like Reshiram and Zekrom and Kyurem. And Genesect is really cool, honestly. Victini is nice. I like the concept of the legendary Musketeer quartet and how they actually have a little event in Black White 2, because I did do that event, actually, where you get to teach Keldeo Secret Sword. And Dream Radar is kind of interesting. Dream World was an interesting gimmick, but they kind of lived
past
their welcome.
Well, like I said, it was the only way to get non-Gen 5 Pokemon.
Oh, and Black White does have some weird version exclusives with, like, the Black Tower and the White Tree Hollow in Black White 2, and in Black White 1 they have the Black City and White Forest. That was a really interesting addition, and the Entralink, which actually made it me want to actually do opposing versions more with friends. I think Black White did a pretty good job of saying, here's two separate versions, and here's a little more incentive to actually play with someone who has the opposite version. I would have liked to see more of that in other games because, you know, most of the time it's just version exclusives, and there are still version exclusives, but they diversified the differences a little bit more in this generation, which I thought was great. Yeah, that does cover it. I haven't said everything I want to say. Justin, if there was anything outside of Conquest, you did play Black, so you did play White, so you do have some stuff to say here.
You say Sharon and them got character development. All I saw was fresh meat.
Well, you didn't really pay attention to the story that much.
Well, I did pay attention to the story. Every time my rival would show up, it'd be like, oh, you want me to beat your ass again?
To be fair, they show up a lot. You get 5 fights with Bianca, 7 with Sharon, and 5 with Ed.
I can actually appreciate the fact that they fight you more, because I feel like the rival battles are too spaced out, to be honest. I mean, I understand it's because it gives you a kind of sense of progress, but they're too far in between to really get any kind of attachment to them. His original name is Blue. Does Blue fight you more or about as much as Silver does?
I'm trying to think. I'll count it up and I'll get back to you, but continue talking.
Yeah, but, because I kind of like what happened there. I mean, I don't think it was too much, but he definitely fought you enough to say, wow, this guy's a fucking asshole. So, I kind of did appreciate the amount of rival battles, because I honestly think there's never enough in Pokemon games. And, when you do see them again, it's almost like to the point where it's like climactic, so it doesn't matter anymore.
And then you know what? I'm going. Oh, sorry. Go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, and then you beat their ass, and then it's like, oh, well, I guess that's it then.
All right. So I'm going to disagree with that actually, because I think that rival battles are more spaced out, they feel more important when you actually fight them.
Well, my problem is,
I think there needs to be a balance. I think for each rival that you have, there should be enough fights that you don't feel like they're really just kind of taking a back seat as a character that's supposed to be, you know, against you, that's trying to push you to continue. But at the same time, you don't want too many that they don't feel significant. So you need a nice balance. You need to have something in between.
I feel like aside from the, you know, anticlimactic, like, ending to, like, their meetings, I feel like the opposite gendered character has, like, the perfect balance of how many fights you get with them in Gen 3.
I actually think that they could have done more with the Gen 3 rivals, so I'm going to disagree. I think a little bit more frequency is... as I was actually about to cut you off, though, for Blue, you fight 8 times over the course of that game. And Silver, if you're counting his last rematch in Indigo Plateau, he has 7.
Wow.
So I think the magic number is about 6 or 7. I think the rival of Ruby Sapphire and Leaf gave you...
What would you say the rival is in? Rivals in 5 are...
5, technically.
They give you 5?
There's the one, like, level 5, or like, 1 level 5 versus 1 level 5 fight. There's one in Rustboro City. There's one right before you get to Mauville.
Oh, the Rustboro City one, that's right.
Yeah, that one's actually completely optional, but it's there. So, I count it.
Oh,
I forgot about that. Yeah, because then there's the one on the way to Mauville, and then there's the, what's the 5th one, then? Because I know there's the...
There's the one on the way to Mauville, and there's the one when you're, like, right in front of Fort Tree City.
Yes, there's that one, too. Okay, so yeah, there's 5. Alright, but continuing on with what you were saying, Justin.
Oh, I was just going to say, it's mainly because, like, fucking the rivals, what I was actually going to say was actually a question. Is the number of rival fights you have in 5, is that, like separate? Like, is that, like, all Sharon or something, or is that, like, them both combined?
In total, there's far more, obviously, but no, I actually said for each one, Bianca's 5 for her. Sharon is 7 for him, and that is counting the one the after you beat the game rematches, by the way. And then N is 5, including the fight with him at the end of the game.
Yeah.
So if we don't count the after game rematches, Silver has 6, Bianca has 4, and Sharon has 6.
Okay. Yeah, because I was trying to make a comparison, because it'd be like, if it's just, like, combined, like,
if it's combined, then they have a total of 17 rival fights.
No, but I was going to say if, like, because I think I misheard you, I thought if it was combined and it only went up to 5, it's like, wow, they really don't fight you enough, like, by themselves to
get
much
about
of an
separate
impression. Yeah. But, yeah, beyond that, really, like, I think if there was about that level of rival fights, like, every generation, I think I'd be okay with that. Because then you would actually care about your rival.
I think that's actually probably why Hugh was not that great a rival, because his fights are so badly paced. Like, you fight him once, and then twice, and then, like, you just don't fight him for a very long period of time, and then you fight him, like, 3 times in quick succession. It's like, what are you doing, Hugh?
But at the same time, there is also Colress.
Oh.
That is true, that, but I think he only gets one solid fight in between that span of time that you don't fight Hugh.
That is true, but, you know, still, he's there.
That's true. All right, but if you don't have anything else to say about the,
I think we're good going to Gen 6 now.
Well, no. Is it no? We have to go to Landon, because Landon has things.
Oh yeah,
to say.
I forgot. You know, we've been talking so long, I forgot Landon didn't say anything.
Landon gets to talk about Conquest, about Gates to Infinity, and if he feels like talking about the main series, he can talk about them too.
Raja just got 7 stat boosts.
I'm not here. I'm not here.
Skill plus 2.
All right. Pokemon Black and Black 2 are for white people, and Pokemon White and White 2 are for Mexicans.
White?
You heard it here first.
I said it. That's what's on everyone's mind.
Landon Cohen for president, and he's going to build a wall between the Pokemon versions.
I think we all know that you make the most racist comments, Landon.
No way, man. That's Donald Trump.
Goddamn. Fakin' Jamaican.
What?
Where are we?
Space.
We're on Gen 5.
Gen 5.
Skank and Pickle.
Wait a second. That's not a Pokemon.
We can talk about Conquest.
later. Pokemon Black and Black 2 are alright. They're okay. They were there. Pokemon... The Rumble games are fun. I always like the Rumble games. I like Blast more than I liked you. I like the original one, I think, the most, honestly. WiiWare. Gates of Infinity is fun. It's the worst, objectively, it's the worst Mystery Dungeon game, Pokemon Mystery Dungeon game to come out, because you can't do multiple missions at once. That's bad. That's bad news bears. That doesn't make it, like, fun. Where was I? What else? Pokemon Dream Raider is probably the greatest thing in existence, because you can get Shuckles through it. So, that's that.
So, Conquest.
What about it?
You're not going to talk about it?
It's fun.
All right, so if you don't have too much else to say...
So moving on to Gen 6 now.
But Poke Pal Park.
Okay, do you want to talk about Poke Park?
All right, I forgot about that
game.
What
about Poke Park 2? Because they made 2.
Do you want to talk about them?
No.
Okay, so we're going to move on to Generation 6. Generation 6 has... begins with Pokemon XY's release in the fall of 2013, and also consists of Pokemon Super Mystery Dungeon, Pokemon Alpha Sapphire and Omega Ruby,
and the upcoming Pokemon Rumble World, which we will not be able to talk about because we don't have it yet because it hasn't come out.
But it is out because it's a freemium game that you can already download. They're just making a retail copy, which removes the freemium garbage. So you can go play it. So
I can go play it, but you're probably the only one that's actually touched it.
I haven't played it because it's a freemium game. Because it's a freemium game, and they're like, you should play this. I'm like, no, I'm going to go play Pokemon, or not Pokemon, I'm going to play Nintendo Badge Arcade.
Let me see if there's anything else besides Generation 6. No, I think that's pretty much it, so we're going to just talk right about it right now. Jack, Generation 6.
Hold on. I got to kill this fucking
killer good
Michael Keaton.
Kill Michael Keaton. Do it. Kill him IRL. If you don't, I'll cry.
All right, whatever. I'll just close this. Okay, so Gen 6, X and Y. They're all right.
They're garbage. That's what they are.
Oh.
Don't lie.
I love how your opinion on every Pokemon game, except for Gen 2, is, it's all right.
It's garbage.
And then Gen 6 is, it's garbage.
Gen 3 is garbage incarnate.
Whoa.
It's water incarnate, actually.
I will stop this recording.
Do it. Do it, pussy. You won't.
I will.
Don't
do
it
right now.
All right, can we just talk about the games, please?
I'll close the call out before you stop the recording.
Pokemon X and Y, please.
I don't know what to say about it. I mean, it has a few new Pokemon.
We did a review for the Pokemon X and Y. Go watch that.
But I wasn't there for that.
You don't need to talk then.
Anything? No.
He told me not to talk.
I told him not to talk. You can talk now.
Come on, can we just please?
I enjoyed Gen 6. Like, you know, I had fun. They're good. Just not, like, great. Better than Gens 4 and Gen 1. Worse than everything else. It's got, like, kind of, like, what's the word I'm looking for? It, graphically, and not graphically. Graphically, it looks good, but it's got, like, frame rate problems. Something that I hope they will fix with the next iteration of games. I mean, that's kind of what they did for, like, Gen 4. It's, like, Diamond and Pearl. It's, like, they're working with new technology, so it's, like, you know...
Aren't models, like, easier to program than actual pixels?
I don't know. But, fuck. I really don't know what to say about it. I spent, like, 150 hours in this game, and most of that was breeding.
Breeding.
Bonding time?
Oh.
Overall, I don't know. I don't have a lot to say.
Any
Omega Ruby.
Like?
Oh, fuck.
Did you like fairy types?
Yeah, fairy types are good.
Talk about fairy types. The gym leaders of the Kalos region or the Kalos region.
Talk about the Kalos region. What do you think of France?
France. It's all right.
France sucks.
I liked it.
There, it's for you. Okay. France sucks. Don't ever go to France, kids.
Yeah, you'll get shot
at
an Eagles of Death Metal concert.
You'll get AIDS.
You'll get a blowjob from a hooker.
With AIDS.
Oh, that's lewd. The gym leaders
you'll
are pretty good.
You'll definitely get AIDS.
I'm trying to remember most of them, actually.
There's that one punk-ass kid. There is,
Wait, which one's the punk-ass kid?
The one
the
that Ash,
gym leader?
Yeah, that punk ass kid,
Clement.
Clement,
not Clement. Clement is
the great
YouTuber.
Clement. One that really sticks out of my mind for some reason is Valerie.
It's because of the eyes, dude.
She has a very, like, interesting design, and she also uses fairy types.
Her hands are actually penises.
Whoa. I did not sign up for this.
I'm suddenly reminded of the porn parody of Edward Scissorhands called Edward Penis Hands.
I mean, just think about it.
Which is a real thing.
I did not sign up for this.
You never see her actual hands. She's got those really alien-looking eyes. She's a monster girl.
Hold on, let me look up.
She's from Monster Girl Quest.
Valerie.
So you can talk about Omega Ruby off Sapphire.
Okay, I was about to do that in a second, but I love Xerneas. Xerneas is one of my favorite legendaries. I'm trying to find where the fucking new Pokemon are so I can. Roller skates. Roller skates are cool.
Oh.
Mega evolutions. I'm suddenly remembering all the things that I was going to say. Mega evolutions are pretty neat. They're not like amazing, but you know. Let's see. Oh yeah, now I remember all of them. Okay. One thing that I always wondered, what the fuck is up with Ramos's face?
Everything.
It's like he has, like, flesh leaves growing out of the side of his face.
That's the point. He's a grass type gym leader.
He's grass. He's grass incarnate.
But like he has leaves on his face made of flesh.
He has fleshy leaves.
I don't understand, but,
delicious.
Be the plant.
And the bees are angry.
Photosynthesis. Photosynthesis.
Sorry,
yeah,
Justin.
Overall, this game is pretty easy. In fact, it's really easy. It's probably the easiest game in the series. There's like one thing that I'm alright, fucking new Pokemon or whatever. I like Sylveon a lot.
Ew.
Hey. Fuck you.
Maybe later.
You mean to just
Sylveon
you mean to just say
movie.
You mean to just say do you mean to just say fucking ew to every opinion you have ever?
What opinions have I stated?
In before, I don't state opinions, I only state facts.
Well, that's truth, so shrug.
Alright, let's get back on.
Alright,
I ran this thing off track 7 days ago. Don't worry about it.
Okay, so Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire. Some people like to bring up that... Oh yeah, Greninja. Some people like to bring up that I fucking... Omega Ruby and Alpha Sapphire should have waited to come out until they fixed their frame rate bullshit problem. Two things. First of all, I didn't have as many frame rate issues as I did in X and Y. So, you know, they're still kind of there, but it wasn't really like a noticeable problem for me. And two, I don't really give a fuck. So, the Gen 3 remakes are... They're good. They're good. I mean, I prefer the originals, but, you know, I think, you know, for the most part, they do their job as a remake to recreate, more or less recreate the magic of the original games, and
I was just going to say, that's kind of how, like, I feel about the remakes for Gen 2, where my only real complaint about them is I actually prefer the original's soundtrack.
You know, I'm going to say that, too. I do prefer the original soundtrack to, The Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire versions.
Yeah.
It's like everyone for like the longest time was asking for Gen 3 remakes. It's just like to the point where like remake Gen 3 just sort of became like a joke because it was like more or less never going to happen. And then the day it was announced, I was like in the library at my fucking college, and I was just like I was bored and I was like waiting for someone.
You screamed like a little girl.
I was like doing homework, and I was like waiting for my next class or whatever. And I was on 4chan on my phone, and someone on V posted, "Where were you when the Gen 3 remakes were announced?" And I'm just like, "What? That's not real." And then I Google it, and it's fucking real. So I just like, I just get up, I grab all my stuff, I walk to my car, and I scream like a little girl. I was so happy. And yeah, they were good. Thumbs up. Should we talk about Super Mystery Dungeon?
Should you talk about it?
Yeah, I mean, it's up to you if you want to talk about it. It's your time to talk right now.
You have 7 minutes. Go.
Oh, that's more time than I need.
You have 2 seconds. Go.
Fuck.
Oh, wait. Jack's like Frieza. He's bad with time.
He is bad with time.
5 minutes should be plenty.
In 5 minutes, this planet is going to blow up.
Oh, trust me, I don't think...
Episodes later.
Trust me, I think Frieza, even as bad as he is with time, I think he even knows that the filler for Naruto is going on way too fucking long.
Is the filler for Naruto still going on? Because the series ended.
Alright, so let us...
I don't really have anything to say about Super Mystery Dungeon. It's Mystery Dungeon, and it's good. It is very super.
Is it super duper, though? Or is it just super looper?
I think I'm going to go with somewhere in the between those two. I'm going to go I'm going to go with Super Cooper.
Super Cooper. Super Sly Cooper? I'd play
super
that game.
Super Cooper Butt Scooper.
So, if that does it for you, then
but
I guess
Super
I'll
Cooper Butt Scoopers are just
talk.
Legend.
What?
All right.
All right, I'm done.
I'm done.
I got Pokemon X on launch.
No, you're still hungry.
Like I have with pretty much every Pokemon game up to that point. I was pretty excited for the prospect of Mega Evolutions. I think the Mega Evolutions make up for the fact that there's not as many new Pokemon. The Kalos region is it's kind of interesting. I mean, I don't like it as much as I like Unova, but I mean, it's kind of there. It was pretty fun to explore what I did. Musically, I mean, I'm not saying this as a bad thing. I did like music, but like, I think the style of Generation 6's music as a whole just doesn't really capture the same vibes that the rest of the games up till then ended up doing. I was not really a fan of the characters of X and Y. For the most part, Team Flare is...
Oh yeah, Team Flare sucks.
They're just not that good. They're just... I mean... I really could not find too much. I didn't talk about Team Galactic in Generation 4, but the thing that made them somewhat redeemable is they had stupid, like, in-jokes that, if you were, an internet goer at the time... when those communities were kind of booming, you got a lot of stupid jokes that they would have, and they had just had stupid cheeky humor. But Team Flare is just kind of either trying too hard or not trying hard enough to be very charming or interesting, and they just don't. I just don't care for them that much. Although I do like the legendary Pokemon's involvement in XY. Compared to other games, I actually really liked Xerneas and Evoltal a great deal. Back to the gym leaders, I like them personality-wise, but once again, them on the aspect of gameplay, I feel like the whole gym leaders being intense fights has just completely become a thing of the past. I liked Valerie. I liked. Olympia was the 7th gym leader?
Olympia, yeah.
Yeah, Olympia was the 7th gym leader. I liked her. I thought she was cool. And Clement actually was pretty fun. I liked him. I think the pacing was a little off, though, because as Jack has mentioned, between the first and second gyms, there's like so much of nothing. And then
I did not mention
up.
That, but I forgot to. And yeah, there's like the pacing in the game is really bad.
I was going to say you haven't mentioned it in this video, but you have mentioned it.
That is true, yes.
In conversations in the past.
Yes.
A lot. I mean, and very much, correctly so, because it is a thing. I think what Generation 6 was trying to do more than anything, though, was try to improve the gameplay aspect. So, like, when it came to the developing the world of Generation 6, it didn't really come together as well as past generations, because you can kind of see it. Like, they did a really good job with, extending breeding mechanics to be a lot easier, extending training with EV training to be a lot easier, getting stuff like shiny Pokemon is a lot easier. There's just so much stuff that used to be very irritating in the past, still can be a little bit frustrating now, not as frustrating as previous games. It's a lot more accessible, but overall, it is the world that it takes place in because of that, just they didn't put enough effort in. I liked it, but it felt like it didn't have the energy as the previous games had done. Alpha, Sapphire, and Omega Ruby, I have not actually beaten yet, and in fact, I was on my way to getting Kyogre in Alpha Sapphire when I lost my file and I had to restart, although I will say so far that I don't think I care for them as much as the originals. Because there's just, like, just with X and Y, there's just something missing when it comes to, like, the energy and, like what I'm getting from it. But it's fun.
Not enough trumpets.
I like it, but the music doesn't really just sound, like I said, it doesn't capture what it used to. I will admit, though, that Generation 6 as a whole visually, especially in battle, visuals are gorgeous. I am so glad that they finally, because a lot of people were like, this was a big deal for a lot of people. They wanted Pokemon to be in 3D in an actual core game and not on a side game. And they finally got it. They finally got it with X and Y. They finally got it with Alpha Omega. And the battles look great. Like, if you have been waiting so long for Pokemon to come to life on the battlefield, you finally got it. And I will say, to that end, they did succeed very well. Other aspects just don't come together as much as they did in previous generations. So Generation 6, I guess, all in all, I'm just going to say, because this is all I've played plus Super Mystery Dungeon. Generation 6 did really good in the facets that it was clearly going for, did not do good in other facets where it was doing good before. Super Mystery Dungeon, on that note, though, was much appreciated after not really caring for Gates Infinity enough to actually continue it. It's fun. I was a little conflicted at first. I like the way that it was introduced in where you don't just jump right into the adventuring and you're actually kind of like held and moved in slowly for it. I like the way that it did that, because the way that the game seems to want to play out, it wouldn't have felt right to have like that sudden jump in. It's click, definitely
click 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 click
click
click
click. Thank you. I'll definitely say it's good, though. I'm glad that the Mystery Dungeon series is getting back on track with that. I like the little improvements that it made. Believe we've talked about this one before. Yeah, in our top games list when we had it in there. So I think I said all I needed to say about that, and I don't really have much else to say about Gen 6, so that's about it for me. Justin, that means it's your turn, goddammit!
I know!
He died.
I can't do it.
He's dead. He exploded.
What do you call it? Well, Gen 6 is the second generation which I picked something that wasn't... Well, actually, no. That's a lie. It's the third generation where I picked something that wasn't a fire type. Because I ended up picking clunky at the beginning because fuck otter samurais. We have ninja frogs.
Yeah.
And I can debilitate people by attacking them with shurikens.
Yeah.
But I also liked it mainly because it got rid of the whole fucking firefighting finally, and it actually it went backwards. Instead of firefighting, you got fire psychic. It's like what? Greninja ended up being the dark type, and which actually makes it really bad against fighting types. And then the grass type became the fighting type. It's like what?
Except, well, that's the point, because if you look at it, they're actually based on... I actually thought the starters, conceptually, I didn't really care for them as Pokemon, but conceptually they're really cool, because Generation 5 did, like, this weird, like, Chinese Western and, like, other kind of style, Japanese style, but for Generation 6, they did... Chestnut is supposed to be based on a fighter class in an RPG, Delphox is the mage, and Greninja is the rogue, and their secondary types are actually supposed to specifically counter... they're supposed to even harder counter the type that they beat already from their primary type, so that they can just, it's supposed to be each one is very clearly better than one and then very clearly worse than another.
Grass is super effective against water, and then fighting is super effective against dark.
Yep. So they actually planned out the starters in a pretty cool way, I thought.
Yeah, I was like, oh, I wonder how long I'm going to use Froakie before I, like, dump him. Or at least not use him as much because, hey, I can have Charmander in this game. But it's like, no, I think I equally used Greninja about as much as I used Charizard. So he's definitely the Pokemon I've taken to... I can't speak. He's definitely a Pokemon I've taken a liking of the quickest. I think I just like his design. At first I thought he looked kind of weird, but then when I saw what he turns into, like Greninja, I thought, wow, this Pokemon is actually legitimately badass. So, I mean, I think the tongue scarf is a bit goofy, but in a way it kind of fits. So I was like, oh, wow, I got my own, like, fucking Ryu Hayabusa here. It's actually one of the reasons I like playing him in Smash, because I just like him so much. And, I thought the game was definitely pussy mode, because it's like, even if you don't end up, like, grinding to hell and back, all the fucking gym leaders are so goddamn piss easy. And, honestly...
Even if you don't use the EXP share, like, they're not that bad. I mean, I had one close fight with Clamont in XY, but that was it.
Like, when I got to the ice gym leader, I'm like, lol, Charizard for days. And that was the end of that.
Yeah, I don't understand why they would ever decide, hey, let's make the ice-type gym leader the final gym leader. You know, the one that's only resistant to itself and doesn't actually really take defenses well, like, at all. Like,
you know what would be interesting is an ice gym, like, early in the game, like the second or third gym.
That would be interesting, actually, because they typically put it really late for almost no reason.
And then you get to the Elite Four, I was like, wow, I don't know if you're more disappointing or just as disappointing as the gym leaders.
One thing I didn't care about for the Elite Four is the fact that their rematches, they don't even give you extra Pokemon. Like, they just stay at four the whole time.
It's like, let's go to the Battle Chateau, and it's like, oh, you still have the same shitty team. What the fuck, guys? And it's like, fucking, I still think the weakest Elite Four member is Mr. fucking... Medieval Starfish, because all this Pokemon are steel. If you got, like, if you pick Charizard, there's no way you're losing this fight. Especially when his Scizor comes out and you just wreck his day.
Something,
I like Age of Slash, though.
Something that I want to mention briefly, that I forgot to, and Cloud didn't mention either, is that X and Y is severely lacking a post-game.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Like, where Black and White 1, you could argue it was lacking, but you still had a lot to explore, and Black White 2 had a massively, filled post-game. XY
Omega
has nothing.
Omega Ruby Alpha Sapphire has post-game for days.
Which is good,
but
XY had
and it's even like
nothing.
And it's... Oh, sorry.
You get one thing. You get to go after Zygarde. That's it. That's all you do.
Well, and Mewtwo.
And Mewtwo, and I think there's like that one, there's like that detective case or something. I don't know. Well, that's it.
Yeah. At the very least, it's got the best egg hatching spot for, like, I honestly think Gen 6 has the best egg hatching, spot. Because,
like I was mentioning, it's they blatantly, like, mechanically, they put a lot of improvements over past games to make everything easier to do.
No, I mean, like, because you know how it's all hatched by, I mean, eggs are hatched by steps? What you could do is take an egg, or take a whole group of eggs, it don't matter, and go to the city and just circle that fucking Eiffel Tower for ages. Because it goes in a perfect loop, which means as long as you just hold down the button and don't run into anything, you'll be doing that forever. So
I, you know what, I honestly never thought to do that.
I never thought to do that either.
I always just used the long straight line in front of the daycare.
How do you think I hatched all my fucking, like, Eevees that take forever? I just circled that Eiffel Tower for, like, an hour.
That is actually a pretty good idea.
But, like, for those that are not sure, the Eiffel Tower is Clement's gym thing.
Yeah. do you have anything to say about Alpha Sapphire Mega Ruby?
I played more of it than I have of actual Gen 3, so I kind of know a little bit of the differences, but for the most part, it almost seems like, you know, like, point for point, like the exact same kind of game, just, you know, with Gen 6 stuff, and I like it, it's just, I'm just not far enough in it.
Alright, Landon, take it home, tell us how Pokemon XY and Omega Elf are crap, and tell us how good Super Mystery Dungeon is.
Well,
point to the doll where X and Y touched you.
What?
He touched me in the hair because he looks like a Dorito. Dorito.
Let's talk about how fucking stupid it is that they introduce fucking Dorito Head and they expect you to not believe that he's the villain. And then when they reveal that he is the villain, you're supposed to be fucking surprised.
Listerine was the villain all along. I never use mouthwash now.
No, it's like, shit. Dorito's
it's
never
like he has the exact
before.
Same color scheme as Team Flare. Like, how the fuck are you going to try to deceive anybody?
I don't get it.
Also, he just has the look of a villain. I mean, who the fuck has hair like that aside from a villain?
Also, the genocide thing.
Main characters in an anime?
The genocide thing.
I was going to say, he does look like he could be the protagonist of a card game anime.
He could be Yugi.
What's the difference between having, like, Xerneas or Wyvetal? Like, what changes the plot that it's, like, less ass?
He's going to make for everyone.
Yeah, in Y version, he wants to just destroy everything. But the weird messed up thing is that in X version, his motivation is that he wants to grant everybody eternal life so that they all have to suffer the lack of mortality that he feels that he's left with also because of what had happened, what happens in the game. It's kind of crazy when you think about it. He's like, I'm going to make you all suffer by giving you immortality. It's like, what?
Whereas in Y, he's just like, disappear for good.
No.
In Y, he's like literally no different than Cyrus, just end everything out of existence.
Y is completely off his rocker.
So yeah, Landon, you can continue.
But... but X and Y... They were all right. Yeah?
Oh my god, that's the most positive thing you've ever said about those games.
But Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald were garbage, and they should feel bad.
Well, that didn't last long.
Okay, I'm ending the call now.
Wait. You have to let him talk
about Super Mystery Dungeon is a good game. And you should feel good. You should go out to your local game store and go buy one today.
And ask for a download of Lexine's Quest.
You know what's funny is that in the same game where... Okay, in the same generation, Generation 6, there's the remakes of Ruby Sapphire. And in those same two generations, Landon prefers the side games to the main series.
When don't I prefer the side games to the main series?
I think there's a 3 for Gen 3. I think Illuminati has to be confirmed here. Landon, you're the Illuminati, aren't you?
Don't tell anyone.
I figured it out.
If you tell people, then I have to kill you.
I am Looker.
Justin, do it.
Oh. I decided to kill you.
Justin's going after you now. there hasn't really been any...
still in this call.
Pokemon, what is it, Pokemon Shuffle? Is that what it's called?
Yeah, there's Pokemon Shuffle.
I haven't played it. There's the Pokemon Picross or whatever now as well. That's free to play. You can play that. I haven't played that. I'm just trying to pull as much garbage out of my ass because you're just like, what's a Pokemon game? And I'm like, I don't know.
Is this something you eat?
I think you might be onto something. You might eat it. You know what my favorite Pokemon game is?
Mm.
What is my favorite Pokemon game? My favorite Pokemon game is Shadow the Hedgehog. Shadow's my favorite Pokemon.
Out of the Edge.
Digimon Cyber Sleuth?
Digimon Cyber Sleuth is a really good Pokemon game.
Okay, so before we leave, I guess if there's anything we'd like to see out of the Pokemon series that we'd like to mention, we can go ahead.
I'd like a good game.
Utilize triple battles more.
Utilize triple battles more and make a good game.
I would like to see more triple battles and more rotation battles, more basically just use of mechanics that they kind of got rid of after a generation. I wouldn't mind seeing them branch out into even more genres, but hopefully more in the way that they managed to do with like Mystery Dungeon, where it's something successful.
I would like
stayed with them.
I would like sort of like a rhythm-based game, so I have to buy a $200 peripheral in order to play it. So I'd like a Rock Band for Pokemon, basically.
We are seeing a fighting game with Pokken coming up. We are seeing apparently a massive multiplayer game that we have with phone with Pokemon Go that's coming up. That's going to be interesting. So they are branching out, but there are still more opportunities that we could be seeing. Jack, is there anything that you'd like to mention? Things you might like to see?
No.
Oh, he's thinking.
Oh,
he's a dream.
The one thing that I want more than anything, honestly,
$1 million. Your wife is to be real.
Yes, but well, no. I mean, if we're talking like non-Pokemon things, the Cubs winning the World Series this year would be nice.
We're talking about Pokemon.
But about Pokemon, I really want a large, but not too large, explorative region with several different like several different just like biomes. For like location, something like similar to Gen 3, but also different. I want like something that kind of like rewards me for like exploring areas that the game wouldn't otherwise force you to. Because like the last couple of regions, like Gen 5 and 6, region like just design wise in general, I didn't really care for too much. I want like a world to explore.
Jack for president 2020.
A whole new world.
I think I would probably like when it comes to series. I'd like them to expand on Mega Evolutions. I'd like them to give them more to some of the newer Pokemon that they didn't get a chance to. I'd like to see them do a little bit more with the stat tweaking that they did in Generation 6. It was kind of under the table, low key, but they ended up giving certain Pokemon little stat boosts. I'd like to see more of that. To make certain Pokemon more viable. And I would really like to see what Jack said, a very expansive region with a lot of optional stuff to explore. I would like to see something more along the lines of I would actually like to see a less mandatorily HM-heavy version of Sinnoh, where there was like a lot of stuff going on. You had like a snowy area. You had the freaking magma area up in... like two separate parts of the northern part of the region. Something kind of like balancing Unova's lack of HM requirements, which I really, really did not touch upon, but really like, in mandatory areas of the region, but then, you know, being able to branch out and give you more ways to explore like Sinnoh did and what Hoenn did. So I'd like to really just see them play up on their strengths and bring everything together in another region. Also, it would not kill them to make another two regions that actually connect, because, I mean, we haven't done that since Johto, and that'd be really nice to see again. Can we get that just one more time, please?
No. Please? No. Not enough budget. You don't buy enough Pokemon games.
Not enough budget.
You don't buy enough Pokemon games.
I'll buy all the Pokemon games if they do this for me.
You have to also buy Lexine's Quest.
You know what? Actually, they don't even have an excuse. They have, like, amazing opportunities for transportation within the Unova region. They could clearly make a game that connects Unova and another game together. Point blank. They could do it. They don't have an excuse. Besides, we don't want to.
They can do it. We can help.
Justin and Landon, anything you guys want?
I want a new Pokemon Coliseum 3. I want that.
That would be great. That would be great too, actually.
I want that, and I would like a giant Bulbasaur Vine Whip so I could Vine Whip Jack when I feel like it. I would also.
Can Venusaur even learn Power Whip?
No, I don't think so.
Stupid.
It's because people don't make moves for Pokemon anymore. Robots do. Robots have taken over the world.
And Justin?
Wait, what was this thing?
What?
Things you would like to see in the Pokemon series that you may not have seen, or just things in upcoming games that you would like to have happen.
When does Pokemon fight Goku?
When does Pokemon fight Goku?
And why do they rock so hard?
What are friends for?
Alright, so if that's everything, then we appreciate you for listening, and we
will Hi, Bailey.
Hi, Kay Bailey.
Here?
We will see you in our next video. Leave us a comment below also.
Order the
thank
side,
you, and you know, good night.
Whatever you feel like, man. You can do whatever.